हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे टॉपिक इज़ इम्प्लीमेंटिंग मेल मर्ज।
मर्ज इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ वर्ड प्रोसेसर। इट इज़ यूज टू क्रिएट अ सीरीज ऑफ सेम डॉक्यूमेंट्स विद मल्टीपल एड्रेसेस। मीन टू से विद द हेल्प ऑफ मेल मर्ज यू कैन सेंड अ लेटर टू मल्टीपल एड्रेसेस विदाउट यूजिंग द कॉपी एंड पेस्ट ऑप्शन। सो मेल मीन्स मैसेज एंड मर्ज मीन्स अटैच। मीन टू से यू कैन अटैच अ मैसेज विद मल्टीपल एड्रेसेस। देन the main document is merged with the mailing address, hence the name mail merge. It is used to send invitation letters or print certificates for several people. For example, if you wish to inform your customers of a new product, then the company information and information about the new product are the same in all the documents, but recipient information changes, that is first name, last name, address, etc. recipient who receive messages. In mail merge, two documents are created, one with the common content in the main document and other holding the address list is called the data source. Then, how we create the data source? Then first is, what is a data source? A data source is a set of mailing address in the form of a rows and column, generally called the database. The content of the database is in the form of data records. Each row is a record of each person, which contain the various fields such as name, address, pin code, etc. To create an address book using spreadsheet or database is little easier, as they use table format to store data, table format like combination of rows and column. So it is also possible to create an address book during the mail merge process by using the mail merge wizard. For this, follow the given steps. Firstly, create a new document and type the letter to be sent to the multiple recipients. This is working area. Then type your letter here. Then click on tools menu, then click on mail merge wizard option. Then a window will appear as shown in figure 3.38b. then click on select starting document option and then click on use the current document option, then click on next button, then select the document type, then click on letter option, then again click on next option, then click on select address list. Then address list window will appear, which will allow you to create the recipient list and shown figure 3.38 D and E. See here. Then click on create button. After clicking on create button, a new address list window will be appear. Then under the address information section, you can enter the information of the recipient, like title, first name, last name, company name, address, city, etc. Then if you want to fill the data of the recipient as per the same fields, then normally fill the data. And if you wish to customize the fields of the recipient information, customize means you can add, delete or rename any field according to your requirement. Then for this, click on customize button and see figure 3.38H, that is here. Then from here you can add any field, delete any field and rename any field according to your requirement, as well as you can change the order of the appearance of the fields with using the arrows up and down. Then after customizing the fields, enter the data in the new format. After entering the data, first recipient, as shown in figure 3.38G, click on new button to enter the information of the next recipient. After entering the information of the entire recipient, then click on OK button and close the list. Then after clicking on OK button, the save as dialog box will appear. Then write the file name according to your requirement. Then click on save button. Then After saving the list, a window will appear as shown in figure 3.38J. Then from here, select the list and click on OK button. Then after clicking on OK button, you will move to step 3 of mail merge wizard. Then a window inserted address block will appear, which will show the address block. Then check if address the data matches correctly. Then click on next button. Then you will move to step 4 of the mail merge wizard. A create solution window will appear. Here you can set the solution for male and female recipient. For example, in field name select gender option and field value select male or female option. Then click on next button. Now you will move to step 5 of mail merge wizard. Then click on adjust layout button. From here you can set the margin, that is from top and from left. Then click on finish button. In next step, the writer window will display the document with the mail merge toolbar below the standard toolbars. See mail merge toolbar. Then now click on the edit individual documents option. Then you can verify all the letters of the recipients before printing. You can use the other options on the mail merge toolbar, such as to exclude, save merge document, print and send email, etc. To exclude some of the recipients, check off on the checkbox of exclude recipient. To save the merge document, click on the saved merge document button. To print the merge document, click on print merge document button. And to send the same letter by email, click on send email message button. Then next option is printing mailing labels. For this, firstly click on file menu, then click on new option, then select labels option. With this, labels dialog box will appear. Then firstly select options tab. From here select option synchronize content, then click on labels tab. From here firstly select existing database by clicking on database drop down arrow, then select table by clicking on table drop down arrow. Then select label format, that is continuous and sheet. For example, click on sheet. From here select label brand, mean to say page, that is every A4. Then select its type, that is J8160 address, mean to say page dimension. If you want to customize the page, for this click on format tab, then select any option according to your requirement, that is horizontal pitch, vertical pitch, top margin, left margin, column, rows, etc. Then click on save. Now move the database field into label text box. For this click on database field drop down arrow, then select any field according to your requirement, that is for example title. If you want to move title database field into label text box, for this click on this arrow. Same as add all the fields into label text box, then click on new document option. Then format of labels will appear. If you want to print the labels, then click on print label option from mail merge toolbar or press shortcut control plus P. If you want to save labels, then click on save mail merge option from mail merge toolbar. With this, save merge document dialog box will appear. Then select save as a single large document option and click on save document option. With this, save as dialog box will appear. Then write any name and click on save. Then next is removing blank lines from labels. First, ensure that the label frames are showing the field content rather than their underlying field names. If this is not the case, then either press Ctrl plus F9 or choose view menu or field name to toggle the view. Next, Ensure that you can see non-printing characters such as paragraph mark, line break, spaces and so on. If these are not already visible, then choose view menu or non-printing character option from menu bar. Other method is press Ctrl plus F10 shortcut, and third method is clicking on non-printing character option or icon on the standard toolbar. Now you will see that addresses field separation is created by line break rather than paragraphs, as the separation of blank addresses field depend on hiding paragraphs, not lines. You need to replace line break with paragraphs as follow. For this, firstly click on first label. At the end of the last data source address field in the first line of the label. Then press delete to remove the new line character and press enter key to insert a paragraph marker. If the line spacing in the first level is not satisfactory, you may wish to correct this before proceeding by modifying the paragraph style associated with address. For this, click again at the end of the first paragraph to be conditionally surpassed, and then choose insert menu, then click on field option, and then click on other option, then select the function tab, and then click on hidden paragraph in the type column option. Now click in the condition box and enter the details of the condition that defines a blank address field. It has general form of, that is, not. Not character indicates the negative case, and the square brackets indicate the conditions. To test for multiple conditions, use the operator and or between the conditional statements. See here. Then click on insert button. Then if you have a suitable template for future use with the same data source and type of label, then if you wish to save it, for this firstly click on file menu, then click on templates option, then click on save as template to save it as an open document text template. Then next is editing a saved file of mailing labels. For this, firstly right click any correct spelled word in a label record, then select edit paragraph style from the context menu. Then from the paragraph style dialog box, you can make changes to the font name, font size, indent and other attributes according to your requirement. Thank you.